Hey everyone, I am back because there's so much drama happening at the moment. We've got some beauty YouTubers back that we're going to talk about today. You can tell by the title. And before we get into that, I guess I'll still do my disclaimer. I do cuss in my videos. I'm not kid friendly, so if you have little ones around, please watch something else. Come back though, you know, because I'd love to have you here. All right. So, I was going to make a whole video about Tati Westbrook coming back, and then I realized I don't have a whole lot to say. I'm just glad she's back. I think she came back very strong, put together, just beautiful, elegant, sophisticated Tati, and I've been watching everything she posts, so I'm glad she's back. That's pretty much all I have to say about it. However, James Charles is already back. It didn't take him long to reflect and find himself and learn new things and grow as a person. I wish I could grow as fast as these YouTubers who fuck up pretend to grow. You know, if my life could just, I could just sit down one day and be like, all right, I'm done. I have grown as a person. Wouldn't that be nice? Alright, so yeah, I'm here to basically rip apart James Charles's, what did he call it? An open conversation. First of all, and I'll give credit to Nosy Housebrout, she pointed this out, and I'll link her video below, because she's amazing, and I love her so much. But she points out, you know, a conversation, an open conversation happens between people, and let's face it, James Charles doesn't care what anyone has to say. Obviously. So he starts out the video by saying, well, basically, you know, it would be stupid of me to think that I could just come back to the internet and post my regular scheduled content without addressing this. No shit. You think? So right off the bat, it's just like, to me, this, all of this is just my opinion, okay? To me, that feels like I don't really want to be making this video, but I can't come back and do my job until I do, so I'm gonna make this video. That's what that feels like. Let me know if you agree, disagree. Oh, sorry. I've got a cold. I'm so sorry. But, then he moves on to say that he... I'm sorry, I found this funny. He's going to do this video differently. He's gonna sit down and create a fun, awesome look while talking about something serious. And he doesn't want it to be misconstrued or taken the wrong way. He is serious about what he's talking about, and it's a serious topic. He just knows that his last video didn't come off so well. Basically, it wasn't received the way he wanted it to be, and he blames that on it seeming scripted because he's had to say things over and over. And so just to keep his anxiety down and his brain clear, he's just going to put on makeup and then talk about this very serious stuff, right? Ugh. Let's pause for just a second, and then we'll continue. I gotta blow my nose. I'm so sorry. And we're back. See, that was easy. Alright, so I'm just gonna kind of, from this point, instead of going point by point through his video, I'm just gonna give you a broad overview of how the serious conversation, the serious open conversation went. It went a little something like, okay, so... basically, I went through this situation, like, a while back, and it was, like, super embarrassing, but, like, also, there's a real problem here, and that problem isn't me messaging, you know, teenage boys. It's real, the real problem is all these fake screenshots, and these 5-minute conversations, because he says over and over and over and over and over throughout the video, he keeps saying 5-minute conversation. It's a, I have a 5-minute conversation and then they just put all my messages out there. And it's very violating for me. Because your privacy is more important than... Never mind. We're just not. And towards the end of the conversation, he goes on to say that some of these interactions, because he... Okay, we'll just skip around here. At the end, he's like, now I know you're gonna want screenshots and proof and evidence because that's what I did in No More Lies. But, you know, I could say I'm just being the bigger person, and that would be true. But the truth is I don't have any screenshots and or evidence because these were 5-minute conversations. And, well, some lasted an hour or a couple days, but no more than that. It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter. The point was, you're talking to underage kids. So, back to somewhere back in the video. He brings up, of course, he's the victim here, and he does at some point say, I'm not trying to be a victim. But that's basically what this was. So, he brings up the drama channel that had posted the 20 victims, and he's like, there were no victims, and, you know, this is all lies, and he uses someone who came out from his past and then turned around and was like, no, I was just doing this for clout. He uses that as, like, a get-out-of-jail-free card, you know, that because this person did it for clout, everybody's doing it for clout, and... He makes a comment about how if you come out and say, you know, tell your interaction with James, whether it's all true or all fake, you know, it's going to go viral and you're going to get millions of views, and that's just a fact. Again, what the fuck does it matter? You were messaging underage boys. You were sexting underage boys. You were asking for pictures of underage boys. Just, you know? And I just feel like this entire video was, okay, I went away for a little bit, now I just want to be back, so forget it. You know, I'm not going to be charged with a crime, and you can't prove anything, so basically I can sit up here and say whatever I want, so I'm just gonna do a cute look, and we're gonna move forward, because I'm James Charles. So, when he was talking about, you know, him not being a victim, he, oddly enough, is like, well, I'm not excusing my behavior, and I'm not trying to take away or I'm not trying to invalidate the real victims, but how can you be a victim of something that didn't happen? That was the part that really got me the most. I'm not trying to invalidate what these boys are saying that I did to them. My behavior was not innocent. But how are they victims of something that didn't happen? But it did fucking happen. It fucking happened. Oh, what alternate universe. And I know what it is. It's money. It's money and fame. I don't have to be accountable. I'm fucking James Charles, bitch. Oh, I'm so fed up with it. I'm so... not even disappointed, because I believe a lot of people called this from the very last video. And, you know, he talks about how he said he was gonna do better and learn and change and grow. But he said this before. He said it before, then he got caught, and here we are again. And now it's forget everything I did. I can't stand it. I'm trying to think of, oh, yes. So, after he goes through basically saying he's the victim of people lying and all of those things, then he wants to explain to us what he's learned, because he feels like if you apologize and you say you're going to learn and grow, that you have to come back and explain what you've learned and how you've grown. So I'm going to pause again. I apologize. I'm sick as hell. And I don't edit my videos. I just hit that little pause button. So I'll be right back to tell you what he had to say. All right. So James Charles has learned and grown. And he's just a different James Charles altogether. So what did James Charles learn? To check IDs. Which I know may seem like deja vu. I felt the same way because he said it before. And he's like, and that's working out so well. And I've also learned that, like, I shouldn't be so vulnerable and so out there with people and allow them to, you know. He even goes as far as to say, like, and people have tried to sneak pictures of me. So now if someone comes over, you know, I make them leave their phone at the door. I learned to do that. Somebody hit me in the face when I told them to leave. So now I make sure my roommates are home. What the fuck does that have to do with any of your behavior? So you learn how to be safe, like an adult should? Good for you. That has nothing to do with this. Did you learn not to fuck with underage boys? Did you or did you not? Saying that you check IDs and that's working doesn't mean shit. It really doesn't. Not once through this whole video or through this whole process, and I'm getting heated, I'm so sorry, but not once does he talk about his behavior and where he was wrong and how he, you know, did he go to therapy? Did he reach out for help from someone? What did he do to change his behavior? The fact that he's attracted to younger people or younger looking people, has he went to therapy? Is there something that he's done to work through this? Instead of, I check IDs, they leave their phones at the door, my roommates are here. What the fuck? Oh, I'm irritated, but I'm laughing because it's like, what did I expect? I don't know what everyone else expected, but it's just, it's so frustrating that this person continues to be this famous person. And I feel like there was something else I wanted to touch on, and now I'm forgetting it. That ever happened to you? It definitely happens to me. It's just a whole lot of frustrating nonsense. None of it was about the behavior or the actions that he took and that landed him. It was just, these are all lies. People get famous off my name. Everybody wants clout. I'm not going to invalidate victims, but how can you be a victim of something that didn't happen because I didn't do it? And again, I've changed. I've learned. I've grown without showing anything that he's done. None of us want to see screenshots or proof of what he didn't do. We've seen what he's done. What we all want is to see where he's learned from that point on. And, I know what I wanted to speak on. See, real quick, I'm sure there's a million things I could talk about, but one of the other things that he mentioned was that in his last video, he talked about being desperate and looking for love and blah, 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 blah. And how he was also naive in thinking that he could live this Hannah Montana lifestyle where he could just take off his makeup, change his clothes, and be James Dickinson and not James Charles. And now he realizes that he can't do that and he needs to let people get to know him and whatever. Look, all of it's bullshit. Okay, basically, the whole saying that he was desperate, he's just embarrassed that he said that. And the rest of it is, again, bullshit. Because saying that, you know, I should let people get to know me and get past the James Charles thing has nothing to do, nothing to do with who you're getting to know, how you're getting to know them. This whole situation is about minors, about you, sorry, you being inappropriate with children, asking for sexy pictures and sexual interactions and conversations with children. I don't give a flying fuck what James Charles does or how he speaks to somebody, how he gets to know them, if they're of age. And he just didn't touch that topic at all. Not really. So, yeah. Basically, nothing has changed. And it probably won't. There was, you know, of course, millions of views and tons of likes. And it's frustrating. So, I feel like we're back at square one. And a year from now, we'll be making videos about more shit that's come out. Maybe it'll take a little bit longer because he's gotten a little smarter. I don't know. Tati's back. That's good. Okay, that's all the good news I have. That's what went down in James Charles's comeback video. And I think I'm gonna film another video. So if you see me looking like this, you already know the deal. I like to film a couple in a row. I think I'm gonna go take some sinus pills or cold medicine or something so that I don't sound like this. I do apologize. I love you all so, so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.